You're going to be drawing buildings, and you could draw them any kinds of shapes. And we want to draw them fairly wide and show a variety. And if your marker is dry like mine was, you can go ahead and get a different one so that you have a good quality working marker. Get your buildings drawn on, and then you're going to be adding things like faces and details, any kinds of things like that. And look at your reference sheet, your handout, for any ideas. And now I'm just making these spiral dashing lines to mimic Starry Night. If you'd like to add that into your background, you can. Or you could add another kind of design into your background. So you don't have to do this, but it is an option if you'd like. So I'm just kind of doing dashing lines, spiral, and kind of moving that out to create that spirally effect that Vincent van Gogh had created in his artworks. Then I'm going to use another color. To create some more dashing lines, showing the movement. And then I'm going to use cool colors around that. Blues. Greenish blue. Showing movement with these dashing lines. Showing some texture in that sky. And then going back to that greenish blue. Now I'm going to use my markers to start to color in my buildings. I'm just going to focus on the outer layer here. You could use the oil pastels for things you don't want to get colored in. I actually want to use a darker color, not pink. Not a light pink, but a darker tone for that. Maybe orange would be good. We're going to add water to our marker. That's why I'm just painting around the edges. If you want the marker color to be brighter, then you could color in deeper. Okay. But when we add water to this, we're going to be able to use it like a watercolor. And wherever you have oil pastel, the water will not interact with the oil pastel. It won't mix because the oil pastel, the oils in it, they don't absorb water. So they actually, the oil pastels don't blend with the water. So that way, the water won't mix with the oils. Have you heard that saying, water doesn't mix with oils? What I can do if I want this part of the eye to stay white, I can color that in white. And I'm going to do that with all of my eyes because I don't want those to get covered. If you don't care, don't worry about it. But I don't want the inside to turn the color of the building. So I'm going to go ahead and just color in those irises for each of the eyes. We've got the iris, the white part, and then the pupil is in the center. I'm sorry, the iris is the colored part of the eye. Like my eyes are brown, sometimes they're hazel. And then the pupil is that center circle that is black. Everyone's pupil is black. Find my red oil pastel. So I'm going to go ahead and just use this lavender color. Ooh, let's do the teeth white. And again, if you want your windows to stay a certain color, then just go ahead and color those in. You can make them colorful. But whatever you use oil pastels on, that will resist the watercolor. And it has a cool effect too. I love the way that works and turns out. And you could always add more color at the end. So. Now for that watercolor. So here's the marker, and I am just using water, and I'm moving that paint inside of my shape. So I think that I want to add more color to my door. So I'm going to add some lines to my door. Before I paint over it. And I'm going to add some white to resist the paint color, which I love doing. And then I think I'll add a couple of lines of this. And now I'll go ahead and continue adding water. And it should resist wherever there is that oil pastel. It should resist. Sometimes if we don't paint it thick enough, it might not work as well. But that is how it goes. I can paint over the door now. And that is one of my buildings that I have covered. You can do the same effect with the top. You can also just use the watercolor. So I'm going to go ahead and use some watercolor for the top. And as you see, wherever I put the oil pastel, it's kind of going over it. And I can add a little more water to make it a little bit lighter blue if I don't want it to be that dark. Just going to move that paint, add that water, move it across. Don't do your best to not mix the markers with the oil pastels, just so that way we're not ruining the markers, okay? I did that by accident right there, but I stopped doing it because I don't want to mix them. I'm also going to use a little more oil pastel color to continue coloring in some of these areas. Of what kind of looks like cheese. your water is dirty, you can always get some fresh water. So that way you have the color that you'd like. Yellow's not spreading as well, so I'm going to use a little yellow watercolor. And there it is.